when your child is diagnosed with a serious heart condition, kind of makes you take a big breath. The wheels start turning in your mind and in your heart. How is this gonna change our family? How's it gonna change Ben's life? What are his chances?
In his 3-month checkup, his pediatrician heard a little heart murmur that persisted, and so his pediatrician suggested we see a cardiologist.
The doctor diagnosed him with a hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, which is basically a thick heart.
One of the first things the doctor explained was he'll have it the rest of his life and that there's no cure. We decided that that doesn't mean Ben's life is going to be short.
Why worry about something today that hasn't happened and you really don't know if and when it'll ever happen? We turned to God and said, God, thank you for today. And thank you for giving us this beautiful little child.
Ben and I really were best friends growing up. He was only a year and a half younger than I am. Ben made it so hard to remember that he was suffering at all on a daily basis because he was so happy and joyful all the time.
When he was a little boy, he would tell us that his heart was bumping. And sometimes his heart would beat fast. And so that was his clue to us that he was experiencing an arrhythmia.
The first time he cheated death was when he was 4 years old. He had a 45-minute long seizure and almost didn't make it. He saw a bright light that he knew and his heart was an angel. After that, he had a tonsil surgery where he had his first cardiac arrest, and thankfully they revived him. On December 6th at his high school, he had a second cardiac arrest.
When I got to the hospital, and he was very disoriented, but he was talking. So we obviously weren't out of the woods, but I was just so thankful that he had made it. Then we unraveled what had happened.
His heart did stop beating for a full 3 minutes. And during those 3 minutes, he had a vision where he awoke in what he described as the waiting room of heaven and said he experienced a profound, unexplainable peace.
He was standing in front of a mirror. He didn't see just his reflection. He saw his whole life flash before him. It says it was the best feeling. But even after he came back from that experience, he was struggling spiritually. He was struggling with dying.
I found him sitting out on our dock. So I asked him, Ben, what are you doing out here? And he said, well, recently I've been coming out here by the stillness of the lake and the quiet to ask God questions. What happened in his vision, he said that he believes that God let him experience that so he wouldn't be afraid of dying and so he would know that heaven is worth it. And so I asked him, were you happy that you woke up? And he started crying really hard and he said, I guess. And that was really hard. It was really hard for me to hear. And so I told him, Ben, I know you may not want to be here right now, but it is for a very important purpose and your life is a gift and you have to use it. And he said, I think you're right.
We were anxious that we weren't in control. We were out of control and his condition was out of control. We couldn't help him like we wanted to. We looked at Philippians 4 verses 6 and 7, where it says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. I looked up to Ben, I said, Ben, you know more about this peace of God than we do. Would you tell us what it was like? Explain it to us. And he said, you know, that peace is so amazing, it's so hard to describe. He said, but you don't have to worry about me. I'm good. He says, I've got that peace that it's talking about right here.
Christmas morning for our family means getting up really early in our jammies, opening presents and making that last as long as we can.
It was right after that that he and his brother went outside.
I looked out our kitchen window and I saw some neighborhood boys jumping on the trampoline and Ben there with them, videoing them, and he was smiling really big. I didn't realize that would be the last time that I saw that smile. And I looked out the window. He had already passed out.
We rushed out there and we began administering CPR right away.
Ambulance came, things were frantic and chaotic. So we went on to the hospital, and there was finally a point where the doctor confirmed that they did all they could do.
We had to start dealing with reality and the fact that our son had just passed away. Are you going to believe everything you've always believed? That there's a God? That there's a heaven? And that your son is going there? It was hard to leave him. But, you know, the truth about God is what makes the difference.
And some friends today asked Sean and I what we thought of the video, and we didn't know what they were talking about.
We sat down as a family and watched the video. He's got this unbelievable smile on his face, and you can tell he's at peace. This peace that he talked to us about and he prayed for us to have.
Just a couple days after Ben passed away, his video had already received millions of views. People were connecting with it, and God was using it to reach their hearts.
And there were these amazing stories of people saying, I didn't believe in God before. I just thought all that was a story. Or, I want to know more about God. Where can I go and find out? And I feel like I had a front row seat to God's big plan. It was amazing.
He just simply said, this is my story. This is what I believe. What do you think?
I think he was being called back home. But he had a job to do before he left.